We are with Amre Moussa, General Secretary of League of Arab States. Thank you, Mr. Moussa, for joining the conversation promoted by Barilla Center for Food and Nutrition. According to several economists, we will be almost out of the present crisis by the end of the year. But some important global problems will last. Hunger, food security, energy and climate change could get even worse. In your opinion, which are the priorities to enable a real sustainable development that includes also poorest countries?
Well, first of all, the conclusion of the discussions in this forum did not really reach the conclusion that the crisis will be over, the current crisis will be over by the end of the year. Opinion differed between those who are who say now we are on the track towards a solution. Others say no, it is a bit too early to decide. However, all of us in the forum, and I believe all over the world now, know that there are new items, new problems that affect the international community. For so many decades, even centuries, political problems dominated. Now, and then economic problems also dominated. Now it is a new set of problems about climate change, about environment, about food, about water. So time has come for us to decide that those items need to be put on a priority list and to discuss them, especially that they, all of them affect all countries, rich and poor. But some of them, like food or water, do affect more the developing nations rather than the industrial ones. And among developing nations, there is a group of least developed that need to be put on a special care list.
How important is the effect of agriculture and food security in the process toward a sustainable development?
This is a very important thing. The food shortage, the crisis in food, in nutrition, and the new projects that should be addressed to agriculture to promote it in a better way, to produce more and to feed people more, in particular in Africa, in particular in the totality of the third world. But I put an emphasis on the situation in Africa in particular.
In your opinion, which actors will play a key role in the future of sustainable development? NGOs, national governments, companies, universities, media?
All of them, all of them. You cannot depend on NGOs alone. You cannot put the whole burden on governments alone. In fact, governments, NGOs, the international organizations, specialized agencies, all of them will have to cooperate to play the same role together.
Global problems of the planet should be solved thanks to a multidisciplinary approach that takes into account economics, environment, health, and culture. How much do you agree with this, and do you think that policymakers are adopting this kind of approach?
That is what caused the problem to get more complicated. It is sometimes it's a question of charity, a question of internal political agenda to show that the government is interested in or helping other governments from that angle alone. But the matter needs to be more seriously addressed. There is an acute problem. So it's not a question of serving this or that purpose internally or internationally, but to feed those people, to deal with this problem according to the what the problem means to the people, regardless of whether you win or lose elections in your own country. So this is, it needs a new approach. This new approach has not yet been elaborated.
As an opinion leader, what do you think we can expect from the coming years?
Well, first of all, we have to agree, the international community has to agree on a certain plan and on how to deal with problems and the priority of problems, the water, food, or whatever, the climate change, health situation, the epidemics. So all of them should be given, should be accorded priority, high priority. But how can we deal with all of them? You cannot do that by just meetings and forums for debate. This has to be put before the United Nations. And in my opinion, and here I agree with the approach followed by the United Kingdom, that the Security Council should address this problem or those problems. Security Council used to deal with political problems, security problems, but those have become more acute for the stability, for the security of the world than some, of course not all, but some political problems. So in, and I believe that the United Nations Security Council will have to put all those problems on its agenda.
Are you optimistic?
Well, you know, I must not express despair. Now with the awareness growing about the problems, about the dire situation in Africa and in certain other least developing countries, I must be optimistic that the international community will not let the situation deteriorate further.
Thank you very much, Mr. Moussa.